Hey guys, welcome back to Magic TV. My name's Craig. It's 9 o'clock on a Sunday, which means it's time for a review show special. And today we're going to be talking about Vox by David Jonathan. Now, what is Vox? Well, Vox has been setting the world on fire. Vox is a new trick that's been brought out by Murphy's Magic and David Jonathan. It's not an app, but it is technology-based. It's something that happens on your phone that basically allows you, in a very clever way, to get Siri to be the, to get Siri to be, how do I describe this? Siri's basically the magician. I know it sounds crazy, but that's what Vox is all about. It's a system that you put into your phone that's not an app, it's not a web app, it's something else. I don't want to give too much away, but what it allows you to do, it allows you to make Siri your assistant, or even make Siri the mind reader and be able to read minds, which is a really cool idea. And there's a lot more going on behind the scenes with Vox than you would possibly imagine. So when you get it, it comes with everything that you need to put onto your phone in order to make Vox work. Like I say, it is not an app, but it is something that you're going to have to put onto your phone. It also comes with a tutorial that's about an hour and a half long, plus an extra half an hour or so in the Facebook group. You've got about 2 hours of tutorial, and David goes through everything with a fine-tooth comb. He's got multiple different ways of doing Vox. He's got multiple different ways of doing the routine. He's got multiple different ways of basically performing the trick. Now, before we go any further and we talk about, you know, the pros and the cons, I had the opportunity to sit down with David and have a little bit of a chat with him about Vox. So before we get any further, let's have a look at this interview. This is an interview with David Jonathan. We're looking at Vox. So I am joined here today with one of my favorite creators in the whole world, a man who for the last 2 or 3 years has been setting the magic world on fire, releasing trick after trick after trick with every company under the sun. Every single one of them has been a hit, and he's not slowing down anytime soon. He's now set the world on fire again with his brand new trick that he's bought out through Murphy's Magic directly, and that's Vox. And I am, of course, talking about the legend himself, the one and only David Jonathan. How are you doing, David?
Is that me with that wonderful intro? Oh my God.
That's you. You are, though. You are. I mean, seriously, from my point of view, you came onto the scene about 3 years ago, like really seriously started making an impact everywhere. And there's very few people that release as much magic as you at such a high level. I've never seen a bad David Jonathan trick. And as well as that, it's always so eclectic. Like one day you'll come out with a mentalism trick. Then you'll come out with a trick with a self-working trick with a regular deck of cards. Threesome is still my favorite go-to trick with a regular deck of cards. Then you go into something completely different. And now you're kind of going into the tech side of things. Yeah. It's like incredible how your brain works. You have this ability to take principles that have been around for a long time and infuse them with a whole bunch of creativity and make them relevant again and really kind of bring stuff out that is super commercial. And I see it over and over again. And it's such an interesting approach to everything that you do. I mean, I think of some of my favorite tricks that have come out in the last year, color test, Stroop test, everything, you know, color sync, sorry, yeah. Everything. I mean, it's just super high quality. You're killing it.
I was just going to say thank you so much, but continue to praise me. Go ahead.
Well, it's true. It really is. And now you're back again with your second Murphy's release. Is this your first or your second?
My first one, actually.
I mean, you've worked with everyone
first
else.
Of many to come.
Might not work with Murphy's as well. And this is, when I first saw this, I thought this was going to be an app. Because I didn't see anything. I just saw a performance. I was like, oh, that's a clever app. I wonder how that worked. And then somebody told me, there's no app. I'm like, what? They're like, no, you just use your phone. I'm like, come again? And you know, the approach that you've taken to do, you know, I don't want to give anything away, but the approach you've taken to do what you're doing with this project, it's genius. It really is.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Yeah, I'm sure some people were a little surprised when they see me now diving into, sort of the tech space with Magic, but it is something I've been passionate about and work on behind the scenes for a while, and I'm excited to bring this out now. And yeah, I'm not the first to sort of do card tricks, with Siri using what I'm using on the back end, but the way that I've structured it here with the freedom and all the conditions of it being so hands-off with the spectator cutting and what's going on behind the scenes just really amps this up to the next level. So I'm glad to see that so far the response has been pretty fantastic just in the past couple of days. And yeah, it's been a fun one.
And I think what people need to understand, and what I didn't understand until I watched the trailer, is just how bloody clever this is. Like, it's very, very clever. It's not just a case of you forcing a card and Siri telling you what the card is
Correct.
or anything like that, which has been around since day gone by. You
Yeah.
could literally have somebody name any card, no force at all. You can have them cutting a deck randomly over and over again. You can then have somebody, you can then say to somebody, we're going to ask Siri to name a number. Siri's a mind reader. Siri names a number. You don't touch the deck ever. You deal down to that number, and that card's there.
Yeah.
That's
And then
killer.
you can, without even touching the deck or the phone again, you can instantly repeat it with having them continue to cut with a different card, different number, which is just wild. So, I mean, one of the things on this is that I kind of took a page out of the Craig Petty book because it's a fairly long tutorial. It's about an hour and a half and then another 30 minutes in the Facebook group. But there are probably around 10 different variations of how you can perform this. So what I really wanted is, it's based on the core method, but there's so many ways that you can achieve it because everyone's going to be different. My personal favorite is on there. I've heard other people say they prefer other versions on there, but that was kind of the goal with this. So you can achieve all that stuff, but there's all different ways of doing inputs and doing other things that you have to do sneakily, sort of, that's right for you. So, I mean, there are some versions where I don't even touch the phone or the deck at all. Right? I mean, it just happens. And the other thing about this whole thing as well, no matter what version you're doing, is if you know me, aside from hoping bringing something new or clever to the table, but it's all easy. And with this, you look at ACANs out there, or even with some of the methodology behind them, there's a lot of math or memory work. This is nothing. I mean, it's literally dead easy to do. So, yeah, I'm really proud of it and hope everyone's joined it as well.
It's amazing. It's absolutely incredible. And it was nice to see full live performances as well. You had Hav going out on the streets and getting some killer reactions and just
Dude, he's
seeing it.
so good. Such a good performer.
Oh man, when you're releasing a trick through Murphy's, why bother performing it yourself when you've got Javier there that can do it for you and do it just like incredibly? That's my
I
answer.
know. They were like, yeah, we're about to go with Javier and film. And I'm like, yes, he's going to kill it.
It's funny because it's true, man. He is great, and you learn so much from watching him do it and just seeing how hands off it is and the reactions that people give. Because a lot of the time, any card at any number is considered a magician's trick. Like it's like,
Yes.
oh, only magicians enjoy that. I disagree because, as you know, I love any card at any number. But I mean, this takes the argument and flushes it down the toilet, as far as I'm concerned, because this is no longer you doing an any card at any number. This is Siri being a mind reader. And what an interesting hook that is. Hey, did you know Siri's a mind reader? You didn't? Oh, let me show you that. Immediately, you've got my attention with that
They're
one.
not thinking card trick now, right? They know this is something different with their phone, and it's something they use every day and can relate to. So it's interesting because, oh, he's gonna show him some Siri. I've never seen that before. And also, wait, what? Siri's the best mind reader in the world? Like, what are you talking about? You make an outlandish statement like that, that now they're intrigued and want to see more. So, I think one of the problems, as you mentioned, is ACAN doesn't have that natural hook line. But when you just start with that premise, like instantly they're motivated to see more. So I think that sort of bringing technology into it just adds sort of the relevancy to these times. And, especially when you look at things like ChatGPT and all that making waves, it's very relevant to what's going on when you're talking about AI.
Oh, it really is. It really, really is. Then you've got the Facebook group, and you alluded to the Facebook group earlier on.
Yeah.
But I mean, you see some people and they'll bring out a trick and they set up a Facebook group and it's like the desert and there's
And there's
nothing.
nothing there.
Yours is very vibrant. There's a lot going on in there. And my favorite application, I'm biased because obviously EDC is my trick, but my
Yes.
favorite application and the application I will probably use more than anything else has recently dropped into the Facebook group, which is the ability to do EDC with Siri. I mean, that's incredible. So you can give somebody five receipts, have them think of something. You don't need a crib. There's no crib, no nothing like that. You
Yeah.
literally pick up your phone and you say, "Hey Siri, what are you thinking of?" And then immediately Siri's going to come back and go, "Well, let me try this. It's blah." What? That's ridiculous. Ridiculous.
Yeah. So credit to Javier, again, the legend. He had the idea of combining them both and sort of sent me the thing, and I made some tweaks to it. Now it works. And it's fantastic. And just to allude slightly more on the Facebook group, a lot of tricks come out and we say, oh yeah, we have a Facebook group. And then you join and then it's like, okay, well, hopefully something cool will be posted here. So I don't take that approach. Like when I released Snaps with Dan Harlan, we had so, that was a 3-hour tutorial and we had so much more. It's Craig Petty territory, right? And we were like earmarking stuff like for the Facebook group. So before it even launched, on day one, we had five videos in there for myself, and then Dan Harlan added an incredible routine as well, which easily could have been on the main tutorial, but it's like incentivizing people that, hey, this is going to be a good community, and that Snaps community has grown tremendously. And same thing with Vox. So literally on launch day yesterday, there's over 30 minutes of content there with incredible bonus routines, including the use with EDC. There's another one that basically is a can with an entire kicker twist, which makes so much sense in the presentation with technology that I love. And there's all sorts of extra little tips and tricks in there as well. So I really wanted it so people join and say, like, oh, this is going to be a good community right from the start, planning that out. So I hope that people join there as, the fun continues after the tutorial.
Absolutely. And I think that, excuse me, one thing that I'm seeing here with Vox is that there's going to be somebody super smart that takes your concept and puts something in that Facebook group that just takes it to an entirely other level. There's going to be incredible tricks, incredible routines, incredible ideas that are all based around a core concept that you've developed and are sharing here. And I always find that that's the most interesting part of any project when new ideas are constantly being generated and shared. And that's what I think is going to happen with that Facebook group.
Yeah, I mean, I can't take full credit for all the concepts in here. I'm not the first to explore this, but I think that I've definitely pushed the envelope a lot further to what's been done before. And hopefully, when people see that, they'll continue on that path and bring it to the next level. And there's already some stuff. I mean, like Mike Pilkey, if you're familiar with him, he released a Siri trick using a music like prediction of a song. And he already just posted in the group just for users. And I mean, that's fantastic. So there's even people that are being very generous with other stuff using the methodology in Siri as well that's already being shared and literally launched at the time of filming yesterday. So I hope that that's going to be a vibrant community as well. And I can't wait to see what everyone else thinks and comes up with.
That's brilliant. That's absolutely fantastic. So, outside of that, yeah, obviously, this is a question that I know is going to get asked, so I'm going to ask it. It's only available on iPhone because of the methodology that's being used.
Correct.
You think you would ever be able to translate this over to Android? Is that something that you're planning on doing in the future? Or is this just a wake-up call for anyone that's got an Android phone to wake up and smell the coffee and go,
Come to
by
the dark side, baby. It's better, never better time than now. Yes, it was my goal is to convert as many people to iPhones can and get a kickback off that now. I would love to offer it on Android. To my understanding, and I've talked to, the Josh Rileys of the world, we don't think it's possible at this time, but I'd love to be proven wrong. I'm sort of now that it's out there, if the community finds a way to make it work, I would happen to be more than nothing going to be happier to say that, tomorrow it's now available on Android, but at the moment, I don't think it's a possibility.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Now, before I let you go and we take it back to the studio and give it a full review, I have one other question, which is 2023. Is this going to be the year of David Jonathan? It's always the year of David Jonathan, as far as I'm concerned. But have we got a bunch of stuff coming out this year that we're going to be seeing in the coming weeks and months?
All right. So the last time I think I was on your channel, we did a review show special for Tokan, which was another card.
It's still. Well, no, don't, please don't say another. It's bloody amazing. It's such a really good way of doing any card at any number.
I'm not plugging that because on that interview, I think you said, all right, is this your final like pass at any card at number? Can you put this to bed now? And I said, yes. And then here we are later, a year later, whatever it is, with another ACAN. It wasn't by design. Some things just happened. But then also you asked me, you know, what's next for David? Is this the year of you? And I said, oh, yeah, all the stuff's coming out. And then, like, we had all the massive global shipping issues and all that and a lot of stuff that was
supposed to be out. A lot of stuff that did come out, though. I mean, there was a lot of stuff in 2023. You know, I Color Sync, I think, was one of the best tricks that Penguin brought out last year.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I was nominated for P3 Trick of the Year, and I've been really happy to respond to that. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. I don't want to plug my other stuff. But basically, last year, as happy as it was with what I put out there, it was supposed to be a lot bigger. But that just means that 2023 is going to be the year. There's another thing coming out with Murphy's that I'm super excited about. It's been like 2.5 years in development at this point with them. And it's very, very, very close. So that should be out. I'm not going to put a date on it, but very, very soon. We have projects with the 1914. I say we, myself and Nicholas Mavrasis, my partner in Magic. We are still teaming up together. We have that. There's things coming out with Penguin, Alakazam. And myself also self-producing some things as well. So I can a little bit more confidently say that in March this year, with the lead time that I have left, that there will be a lot more coming out this year that I can't wait to share with everyone. That I'm very excited about.
Amazing. And again, if people want to book you for a lecture, they can do so, right? You are now lecturing all over America.
Yeah. Should we make the announcement on?
We could do. Yeah. I mean, I will announce here that I've booked David Jonathan to be the first lecturer that's going to be part of the, we're going to start doing sort of masterclasses once a month in the Netrics, and it's going to be a different star of Magic every single month. And I've got a list of people that I'm booking to lecture. And the first person that I reached out to who I wanted to do it first was you, because you know what I think about you. I think your Magic's super strong, super commercial, super amazing, and it's something that everybody can do. And I think that's really important with a lecture. It's great watching 2 hours of really complicated sleight of hand and then walking away going, I'm never going to do that. But for me, a lecture's much better if you look at something and you go, you know what? I could see myself doing that. And that's what you bring to the table. It's really clever, really commercial. And more importantly, people watch you do it and you go, you know what? I think I could do that. And that's why you're one of the best lecturers in the world, as far as I'm concerned.
Oh, well, thank you. And I'm honored to be first. And that way, if it's crap, everything else that followed can only go up from there. So get the shit out of the way first, and then the real good stuff comes in.
You're going to be amazing. So I'm going to be promoting that very heavily for all the Netrix users. But you know, I want everyone to go off and get Vox. I'm going to take it back to the studio now and give it a full review. Spoiler, it's great. And I'm sure I'm going to see you on the channel again soon, David, because I know you've got so much stuff coming out that I'm going to have to keep bringing you on. I think I might just end up doing a special segment on you every single week with a new, you know, David Jonathan's trick of the week this week. And we'll get that on. So, you know, I know. And what's your mailing list so that people, because I know you communicate everything
to
you.
Yeah. So if you want to get the early scoop on stuff, be the first to know, davidjonathanmagic.com. Once you go there, there's a little button that says subscribe. You sign up to my email list. I don't bombard you with stuff, but you'll be in the know when things come out. And you get a free trick too, which Craig Petty gave 100% on my review show special. So you'd be an idiot not to sign up, right?
Exactly. It's amazing. There you go. The free trick is better than most people's, like most people's pay. Really good. Brilliant. David, thank you so much for jumping on the channel. Thank you so much for talking about Vox. Congratulations on your continued success. And I will see you again very soon on the Netrix and also on Magic TV.
Sounds good. Thank you for having me.
Awesome. Mate, you rock. Let's take it back to the studio. So that's Vox by David Jonathan, and that's the interview. And I want to say thank you so much for finding the time to do the interview. Now, I do like David. I think he's an amazing magician. He's one of my favorite magicians. But this review is going to be 100% honest. I will say exactly what I think. No holds barred. And David knows that as well. So, with that in mind, like I said before the interview, Vox is a system that you put on your phone, and the main routine is an any card at any number. Now, there's lots of different ways of doing the routine. There's probably about 10 or 15 different handlings and 10 or 15 different options. And one thing that I would suggest you do is watch the whole tutorial first before you do anything, because when you watch it, you'll begin to realize which one's better for you over another. But the whole idea is that you can put your phone down and you can have somebody take a deck of cards. You can have them cut the cards a few times and just point out that every single time that you cut the cards, it changes the position of the cards. They stop cutting whenever they want to. Now, they named the card earlier on, and they can name any card they want to in this particular version. In other versions, you get Siri to name a card, or there's very different ways of doing it. But then you point out that Siri's a mind reader, and you ask Siri to give you a number. Siri gives you a number, you've not touched the cards, they deal down to that number, and the card at that number is the card. Now, it's that clean, it's that direct, and you can repeat it over and over again if you want to, and it's a different outcome every single time. A very, very strong. Now, I did a performance on Jack, so let's have a look at this performance on Jack. You're going to see exactly what Vox looks like. So here's a full performance of the routine. When I've done the performance, I'll bring it back in and we'll have a chat about it a little
Jack.
Bit more.
Hello. I'm going to show you a trick with a pack of cards. I know you like card tricks.
I do.
52 cards. They're all there. They're all different. And you're going to help me with this, because I'm not going to do this trick serious.
Siri?
I've been teaching Siri to do magic, and I have to be honest, she picks it up a lot quicker than math. So starting next month, we're going to be doing the Siri entry. It's going to be Siri, and we're going to eventually have her performing on stage in front of hundreds of people. It's going to be amazing. But she's been starting off with card tricks. Do me a favor. Name a card, any card.
Seven of clubs.
Cool. I want to cut the cards and complete the cut, because every time you cut the cards, it changes everything. And you sure you want the seven of clubs, yeah?
Yep.
Because you can change your mind if you want to. Cool. Wake Siri up. Do you want to cut again? You can cut again if you want to.
I'll do one more.
One more time. Because every time you cut the deck, here's what happens. Every single time you cut the deck, it changes the position of every single card in the deck.
Yep.
Do you want to change again? Do you want to cut again, or is that it?
I'll stick with that.
Okay. So. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to ask Siri. You've heard of something called any card number, yeah?
Yeah.
Where somebody picks a card, names a card, and then the magician tells you the position is in the deck. I've not touched these cards. Siri has not touched these cards.
Can Siri touch these cards?
Not really, no. but let's see if we can do this. Hey, Siri, tell me a number from 1 to 52.
The answer is 34.
34. 34. She says the answer is 34. take the cards, and I want you to deal 33 cards onto the table, turning them face up one at a time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. What was the card again?
The seven clubs.
Really?
Yeah.
You're not going to believe this. Do you know why?
It can't be.
That's the 34th card. She said 34, or he said 34, right?
Yeah.
Have a look.
Flip it up.
Yeah, turn it on.
What? How? That's bonkers.
I mean, seriously, how good is that? I mean, that's a really strong trick. Now, things that you need to note. You don't need to have Wi-Fi. You don't need to have internet. You know, sometimes you're in a gig and you've got those fancy apps that require access to the internet. That's not the case with this. You can do this completely offline if you want to, which is cool. So that's the first big advantage. Second of all, like I said, there's so many different options. Now, the way that I've set it up on my phone and the way I'm doing it is the way that you just saw it there, where you have somebody name a card, you have somebody name a number, and the card, sorry, you have somebody name a card, you have Siri name a number, and then Siri the card appears at that number. But there are lots of other different ways to do it. One of the things I really love about this trick is the hook. I find it very interesting, the hook line being, hey, did you know Siri's a mind reader? I'm going to prove it to you. Siri can read minds. It's a really fun way to go with this particular type of presentation. And it's a hook line. It's a really great presentation. I also love the fact that no tables required. There's no angle issues really to speak of. And you're able to do it again immediately. I mean, as workers go, this is an absolute working routine and then some. You don't need to be a technical wizard in order to be able to do this. You just follow the instructions and you do what David tells you to and it'll work. But having said that, there is also a Facebook group, a very vibrant Facebook group, where people are discussing ideas and options and routines. And a few people are having issues with Vox. But one thing, because maybe they're not following the tutorial correctly or their phone isn't set up in the way that would be conducive for using Vox. But what's really cool is David has gone into the Facebook group and he is so supportive. I had a small issue with a bonus routine and he was able to sort it out within seconds. And he's jumping on there and he's being very active and he's sorting out any problems that people have the second that they have them. And this is the thing about David. He's not just a great magician. He's not just a great creator. He's one of the nicest people in magic. And this is a perfect example of him going above and beyond to make sure that his customers and his end users are having a great experience of his product. Now, talking about the Facebook group, there is bonus routines that are going on in the Facebook group, some amazing ideas. And it's great to see a Facebook group that is so vibrant. One of my favorite ideas was an idea by Javier Femeja, which is combining Vox with EDCeat. Now, obviously, I'm quite partial to EDCeat because it's my trick. And EDCeat and Vox work together perfectly. They really do. It's a really great way of actually using EDCeat. And honestly, this is probably going to be the way that I do EDCeat moving forward, because you can get Siri to read the spectator's mind. Now, I've done a performance of this as well, so I'm going to show you this. This is a performance of EDCeat and Vox working together. You can learn this as a bonus routine in the Facebook group. Let's have a look at this.
I'm going to perform it to Jack. I know you know this. You've seen me perform this before. But I'm going to do that. I've taught Siri to do this trick.
How?
Siri can read minds. And I'm going to prove it to you.
Siri can't read
minds. No, Siri can read minds. You're going to be blown away. So I've got 5 receipts here, yeah?
Yeah.
From 5 different shops. And there's a whole bunch of different things on each receipt. I want you to do me a favour. Go through the receipts and find any item. And when you've got it, remember it and tell me when you've got it. Don't tell anyone, don't write it down.
Okay.
Yeah, you done it?
Yep.
Okay, so which receipt is it on?
It's on quite a few.
Okay, so this is going to help Siri, and you'll see why in a second. Any receipts that it's on, put them face down there, just so we know how many receipts it's on.
Okay.
Okay. So it's on that one. Hang on, Siri shouldn't be looking. Sorry.
Okay, let me check that one
again. Is it okay? Take your time.
No, we're not on.
Okay. So it's on that one, yeah?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Siri, it's on 3 receipts. Okay, remember that, it's on 3 receipts. Don't have it down. This is being filmed, it'll be embarrassing, okay? We've talked about this before. Sorry, just 1 second. We've talked about this, okay? I know you can do this. You know you can do this. I know we've had some hiccups in the past, but just focus, okay? All you have to do is to think positive thoughts. Remember, it's on 3 receipts. So you just need a bit of
pep. He's actually having a conversation with Siri.
Well, let me just ask. Hey, Siri, can you read minds? Hey, Siri. Let me just wake her up. Hey, Siri.
Well, she's not bored yet.
Can you read minds?
I'm not always right, but we can try.
Okay. That seems fairly confident, right?
That's reassuring.
Well, I don't know. Here's what we're going to do. I want you to take the phone. You're thinking of an item, yeah?
Yeah.
What I want you to do is say the thing that you say to wake Siri up.
Yep.
And then, what am I thinking of?
Okay.
Okay?
Hey, Siri. What am I thinking of?
Siri doesn't listen to you. Hey, Siri.
What am I thinking of?
I like a challenge. I feel like you're thinking of Coco Pops.
What the fuck?
So you're right.
Yeah.
There you go. See?
Ah, oh, spooky.
Been training Siri to do magic.
No, I'm
over. Hey, Siri. Good job, Siri. Honestly, you're amazing.
So, I mean, that for me is one of my favourite things that I've seen in a very long time. When somebody can take a trick that you've created and improve on it, well, happy days. And that's what David's done there. I love the idea of Siri telling the people what they're thinking of. And I also love the fact that I can throw the receipts in the back of my phone case and I'm good to go. And if anybody knows that iForce subtlety that I use when I'm doing the separation, I talked about that in EDC, you can do that initially. So you've got a reason to have your phone out. And then you can get Siri to read the minds and you can get them to do the other thing. Just a really nice, well thought out idea with Vox. Look, you've just seen a couple of live performances. There is nothing else to say. You just get the thing, you download it on your phone, you watch the tutorial, you do what you need to do, and it'll work every single time. As long as you've got your phone on you, you're good to go. Now, with the main handling, with the any card at any number, I will be honest with you, you need a deck of cards, and not just any card deck of cards, you need a deck of cards set up in a particular order in order to be able to do this. So please bear in mind that you do need a deck of cards in a particular order. This is an order that a lot of people are aware of anyway, so you might carry a deck of cards like this around with you anyway. For me, I do use a deck of cards in this order, as you will probably know if you are aware of some of my projects, which is perfect because I'm going to be carrying this deck around with me anyway, which means I'm always ready to do this. It packs small, it plays big. David talks about how you can perform this on stage, how you can perform this parlor, how you can perform this close-up, how you can perform it virtually, how you can perform it walk around. It's just an incredible release. I honestly think it's one of my favorite tricks of 2023 so far. And don't look down on this. And what I mean by that is, I know some people are going to go, oh, it's very simple. It is very simple on the surface, but when you actually delve deep into it and you realize what David's done to be able to make this work, it's incredible. And I think that this is a really big addition to the magic world. And I love the fact that it's available to be done offline as well. It's just so cool. So I'm going to give this 100%. I think this is one of the most exciting releases that have come out this year. I'm absolutely 100% going to be doing it. And I know a lot of people that are doing it as well. Unfortunately, it's for iPhone users only. If you've got an Android phone, you're not going to be able to do this. You have to use an iPhone. If you're not an iPhone user, shame. That's all I'm saying, shame. Nemid Phoenix, I am talking directly to you right now. But there you go. It gets 100%. I love it. I think it's great. I think it's a really interesting hook. Siri being a mind reader is great. I'll be honest with you, I'm probably going to be doing the EDC handling more than I am anything else. But either way, this is a great trick and it gets 100%. So there you go, guys. That's another magic review in the bag. That's another review show special in the bag. Do me a favor. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Now, you want to see more videos like this? All you got to do is like the video, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below. And I'm going to be back again tomorrow with another video. So I'm going to be back again tomorrow with another video. Don't forget, if you want to check out my online shop, which is now live with merch and magic tricks, you can go to www.magictv.org. You can get all of my stuff from there. And if you want to go and join the Netrix and see all the fuss is about, you go to www.thenettrix.com. In fact, we are rocking and rolling. We're getting more people subscribing now than ever before. Come and join in the fun just like everyone else is. I will see you again soon. Thank you so much for watching. My name's Craig from Magic TV.